To get regular updates, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. Hello friends, this is Manohar Veera from ExamBeam. Welcome to the series of Modern Indian History. In this session, we're going to see about the revolt of 1857 in India. The Indian Rebellion of 1857 was a major but ultimately unsuccessful uprising in India between 1857 to 58 against the rule of British East India Company, which functioned as a sovereign power on behalf of the British Crown. The event is known by many names, including the Sipahi Mutiny, the Indian Mutiny, the Great Rebellion, the Revolt of 1857, the Indian Insurrection, and India's First War of Independence. Causes of the revolt. Political causes. Lord Dalhousie was the Governor General of India till 1848-1856. Under him, the British followed an expansionist policy in India. Dalhousie, through his policies, had added considerable territories to the British Empire in India. The policy of annexation reached its climax when he implemented the policy of Doctrine of Lamps and annexed the Indian states on charges of misgovernance and absence of an heir. In the course of 8 years, Dalhousie annexed Satara, Sambalpur, Jhansi, Nagpur, Jaipur. This policy enraged the Indian rulers against the British government. As part of the Doctrine of Lamps policy, the titles and pensions of some Indian princes were confiscated. The pension of Bajirao II's son Nana Sahib was discontinued after his father's death, and Rani of Jhansi had been deprived of her right to rule in violation of the recognized Hindu law. Dalhousie further proposed to abolish the title of the Mughal emperor after the death of Bahadur Shah II. Economic causes. The economic policy of the British adversely affected every section of the Indian society. The British exploited the economic resources of India to their advantage and drained her wealth by crippling the Indian trade and industry. Under the British, India turned into a colonial economy to serve the British capitalist interests. Heavy taxation, evictions, discriminatory tariff policy against Indian products, and destruction of traditional handicrafts that it peasants, artisans, and small zamindars. These grievances left the Indian people dissatisfied of the British, eventually turned out to be a bitter enemies of the British. Social and religious causes. The attempt to bring about social reforms in India by the British was not liked by the general public. The social legislations of the evils as sati, infanticide, remarriage of widows, etc. were considered as interference in the religious matters of Indians, about which the Englishmen knew nothing. The introduction of English education, the propagation of the work of the Christian missionaries, and the changing of the Hindu law of property with a view to facilitate the conversion of Hindus to Christianity alarmed many Orthodox Indians. Military causes. The Indian soldiers were considered inferior and were ill-treated by high officers. The high ranks in the army were exclusively reserved for the Englishmen, and the Indians were deliberately excluded from responsible positions. The immediate cause of the revolt was the introduction of the new Enfield rifle and the greased cartridge. In loading the rifle, the Sipahi, before inserting the cartridge, had to bite off its top. It was believed that the grease was made out of fats of cows and pigs. This was objectionable to the Hindus and Muslims alike. This rumor sparked a fire of discontent against the British in the form of revolt. The first sign of unrest appeared in 1857 at Barakpur in Bengal. A Sipahi, Mangal Pandey, on 29th March 1857 killed senior officers on parade and started the revolt. Courts and spread of the revolt. The revolt spread to Berhampur in Bengal. On 24th April 1857, about 90 men of the native cavalry stationed at Meerut refused to accept the greased cartridges. 85 of them were dismissed and sentenced to 10 years imprisonment. On 10th May, the revolt started at Meerut, and mutineers, after killing some of their officials, marched towards Delhi. On 12th May at Delhi was seized and Bahadur Shah too was proclaimed the Emperor of India. The real command was in the hands of Bakht Khan, who had led the revolt at Bareilly and brought the troops to Delhi. In Kanpur, the revolt was led by Nana Sahib, who declared himself of the Peshwa and governor of Bahadur Shah. Tantya Top did most of the fighting. Rebels defeated General Bindam outside Kanpur. In Lucknow, the revolt was led by Hazrat Mahal, the Begum of Awadh. She had proclaimed her young son Brijesh Kadiraz, the Nawab of Awadh, against the wishes of the British. Henry Lawrence, the British resident, was killed in Lucknow. Jhansi. After some initial vacillations, Rani Lakshmibai assumed the leadership of the mutiny. After being defeated at Jhansi, she captured Gwalior with the help of Tantya Top and Afghan guards. Bareilly. Khan Bahadur Khan proclaimed himself as the Nawab and led the revolt there. The other centers of the revolt were Banaras, Allahabad, Gwalior and Nazirabad in Rajputana, Indore, Aligarh and Kota. At all these places, the sipahis killed the senior officers and other Europeans, in many cases not even sparing women and children. They also released prisoners from jail, plundered the treasury and burnt land records and many pieces. However, the superior British force soon suppressed the revolt. Bahadur Shah too provoked to be a weak leader. Delhi was recaptured on 20th September 1857 by John Nicholson. Bahadur Shah was arrested and deported to Rangoon, where he died in 1862. The rebels were defeated by General Havelock in Kanpur. Nana Sahib, after being defeated, refused to surrender and escaped to Nepal. At Jhansi, Hugh Gross suppressed the revolt and Rani Lakshmibai died on the battlefield. Banaras, Bareilly and Gwalior were also recaptured by British officers. The causes of the failure. The revolt was highly localized and restricted to North India. Regions beyond the river Narmada in the south remained largely undisturbed. Chindia of Gwalior, the Holkar of Indore, the Nizam of Hyderabad, the Raja of Jodhpur, the Nawab of Bhopal, the rulers of Patiala, Sindh and Kashmir, and the Rana of Nepal provided active support to the British. The revolt was poorly organized and lacked coordinated planning amongst the leaders. The rebels lacked a common cause and had different goals. The British had better resources and succeeded in suppressing the revolt. They had vast resources at their disposal and were helped by the modern means of transport and communications. They also had the services of capable generals such as Havelock, Outram and Lawrence available, who could plan the suppression of the revolt well and win back their lost regions. The nature of the revolt. Historians have described the nature of the rebellion of 1857 variously. Some call it a sipahi mutiny, since the initial thrust of the revolt in the form of the cartridge episode was given by the soldiers. These scholars also contend that the revolt was not related to the general public so much as the sipahis, and they formed the bulk of the rebels. Nationalist as V.D. Savarkar opined that the revolt was the first war of independence. They feel that the revolt sparked off the discontent of the Indians towards the foreign rule, and they fought bitterly to drive away the foreigners from their homeland. According to them, the Hindus and Muslims participated equally in the revolt and displayed a new bond of unity against the British. The Marxists view the revolt as a soldier peasant struggle against feudal bondage. They contend that Indian soldiers were a peasant in uniform and wanted to throw away the feudal domination infused by the British. On the whole, one may look at the revolt as a product of the accumulated discontent of the people against the foreign government. Now we will see the impacts of the revolt. Policy change. The Queen's proclamation of November 1858 announced the policy of the British government to be followed from now on in India. It announced that the policy of territorial extension was to be abandoned. The native rulers were assured of the safety of their territory, rights and honor if they cooperated with British. The right of a ruler to adopt a child in the absence of natural heir was accepted. The government regarded the native rulers as the bulwark against the masses and henceforth followed a policy of protecting this reactionary segment of the Indian society. A policy of divide and rule was actively pursued to keep the Hindus and Muslims divided. administrative changes. And January 1st, 1877, Queen Victoria was proclaimed as the Queen Empress of India, and the administration of India was transferred from the East India Company to the British Crown. India was to be administered by the Secretary of State and his 15-member council through the Viceroy. The Governor General became the Viceroy and the representative of the Crown of India. Reorganization of the Army. The Army was reorganized to strengthen British control over the country and avert any further rebellions in future. The number of British soldiers was increased and all the higher posts and key positions were filled up by the British. Communal and racial bitterness. The revolt of 1857 created a big gap between the different religious communities in India, especially the Hindus and the Muslims, as each blamed the other for its failure. The Indians, however, developed a deep racial bitterness towards the English and opposed the inferior status granted to them. Okay friends, with this we have come to the end of this session. If you watched till this, you have liked our shows. Please subscribe to ExamBin to get regular alerts to our new videos. Thank you so much. Bye.